Hi everyone, welcome back to Dirty Kitty. So, sideslipping, a technique perfected by glider pilots to bring their aircraft down in the absence of flaps or any other mechanics. So today, we're going to be trying it out in FlightGear on two aircraft, the Cessna CitationX and the Cessna C-172P, a jet airplane and a propeller airplane. Sideslipping is also used, famously, in the Gimli glider incident, when Captain Pearson has to use the technique because the flaps and slats and such are inoperable without any energy from the engine whatsoever. So here we go, taking off in the CitationX, and actually I forgot to pull the flaps in gear. I'm setting the autopilot to follow my current heading, just trying to turn it on first, and also climb all the way to say 1,000 feet. You can do it in any altitude, really. It doesn't really matter. Alright, we have reached the altitude of 10,000 feet and I'm trying to get the speed right. The HUD is now on. Okay, so my elevator is on the left side of the center diamond. And my rudder is on the lower side of the center diamond. My ailerons, that is rolling left and right the way you normally turn in a plane, is above the diamond. Let's start the maneuver. Turn off the autopilot. Enter to get the rudder to the right. Enter manual control. And then move the aileron to the left. Here we go. Rudders to the right using the enter key. Then aileron's to the left until you're not turning anymore, looking at a compass up top. By the way, the red HUD you're seeing here is a lot better when flying in the daytime. Also, gradually tap enter once you're in a stable situation and then, you know, move the rudder further until you're doing what you're intending to do. So right now I'm trying to figure out how to balance the turning rate once the rudder is about, I don't know, a third from its initial deflection. I'm adding in a little bit more rudder. I think I can get almost to the edge on a Citation 10, mostly because we have a lot of altitude here, and now I'm actually managing to climb in the sideslip. Alright, so we're in the sideslip. And it doesn't look like much because our speed is pretty high, but right now we're not heading in the same direction that our plane is pointing. The plane is presenting its side to the air incoming. It might not seem like it, but this actually adds a little bit more drag. So if I were to turn on the engines right now, we'll be falling a little bit faster than we would be if the engines are still on. Let's tap over to the flyby view and see if we can see it. It isn't clear, and I'm going to turn off the HUD right here. But you can see that we're pointing just to the, you know, to the right of where we're supposed to go. Right, so sideslipping in a jet airplane isn't that much fun, really. It's way more fun if you try to sideslip with a propeller aircraft, which is what we're going to do next. We're going to jump in our trusty Cessna 172P, install with everyone's flight gear installations, and then we're going to sideslip it and see how it will survive. And let's get to it. So here we are in our trusty Cessna C-172-2P again, and we have climbed up to altitude of about 1,000 feet. Actually, we're about to level off right here, I believe. And then, we're going to sideslip it and see how far it can fight. The last time I did this, I actually managed to keep the altitude, but just barely, using full throttle, or sideslipping considerably. So, let's see how far we can survive this time, alright? Now the HUD is turned on again. We're taking manual control. Actually, we're on manual control all the time in the Cessna. I always fly the Cessna manual. And then, we're making things work. We're hitting enter in order to pull the rudder to the right. And the ailerons are getting pulled to the left. And you can see that right now we're gaining only a little bit of speed, while dropping considerably in altitude, and we're actually on full throttle right here. So you can see, sideslipping is a huge source of drag, and you really have to be careful doing it, otherwise you can easily end up on land if you're doing this. And by the way, if you feel like you've went too far, you can hit the zero key in order to move the rudder to the left, and thus reduce the drag. Now you really have to be careful managing the aircraft and making sure it's heading in the right direction and not turning. Right now I'm having difficulties pointing the airlines to the correct position now that the rudder is on full right. But I'll eventually home in. But if you can quickly gaze at the altitude, you can see that I'm still at 100 knots, but our altitude has dropped to less than 600 feet by now, which means we're about to run into the ground. So let's enjoy some of these external shots real quick. And as you can see, discounting the turning right there, we're clearly not going in the direction we're heading. You can see it right here. This is a great shot. And actually, we're really dangerously close to the ground right now, so I'll have to pull out of this eventually when I'm feeling it. Yeah, I have to pull out of it, otherwise I'm probably going to run some buildings soon. So zero key pulls me out of the side slip, gradually all the way down to the center, and back into normal flight and normal climbing. Having trouble regaining control there. But everything's working fine. So that's sideslipping, everyone. Thanks for watching, Dora Kitty, and we'll see you again next Saturday. Have a nice flight.